In the previous video, we discovered an interesting data structure, the try. We learned what is a try, what are its advantages, how to implement it, how to insert, search, and delete a string, and how to retrieve all the strings that are stored in it. And we said that in the next video, this one, we will use it to implement the autocomplete feature. The autocomplete feature is usually present in search engines. You start writing something, and it automatically suggests you the results that start with what you wrote. In other words, it shows you the strings whose the string that you wrote is a prefix. For example, if you write TYP, you get strings that start with TYP. First of all, if you didn't watch the last video, you really should do so before continuing this one, to understand how the try works. Second thing, why is the try a good choice for implementing the autocomplete feature? It's because in a try, strings that have common prefixes belong to the same node. So if we want to get strings that start with MACA, we traverse the node M, the node A, the node C, the node A, and we reach the subtry that contains remaining characters of all the strings that start with MACA. We just traverse it as we did in the last video to retrieve them. The code is really simple. The function takes as parameters the try and the prefix. We start at the root, then for each character in the prefix, if we don't find CH in the children, then we have no strings that start with that prefix, we return an empty array. Else, we move to that node in children and we continue. After the loop, we are now in the root of the subtry that contains strings that start with our prefix. We retrieve them with the function we made previously, and we add to them the prefix, because the subtry contains the remaining part only without the prefix. Now that we know how to implement the autocomplete feature, let's implement it in a simple app. I use tickenter to create this window that contains an input text field and a list that will contain the suggested words. For the string that's gonna be stored, I decided to put words of a dictionary, so I downloaded a text file that contains more than 460,000 words and built a try with them. First problem, building a try with that number of strings took tens of seconds, and we don't want to waste that much time every time we launch the app. What I did is that I built the try, then converted it into a JSON file, so that when the app launches, it just loads the JSON file instead of building the try again, which takes way less time. Note that in our JSON file, a node is not represented by an object of type node, but by an array of two elements. The first one is the boolean that says if it's an end of string, and the second element is a dictionary that maps characters to nodes. So node is end becomes node of 0 and node children becomes node of 1. After it, I created a function that's gonna be called every time the user writes or deletes something in the text field. This function starts by deleting the suggestions, checks that the input is not empty, grabs the text on the input field, generates the strings that start with it, and puts them in the list of suggestions. And this is what happens when we start typing. As you could see, there is a delay when we start typing, especially for the first letter, because there are thousands of strings that start with A. I thought of a possible solution for that, is to limit the number of suggestions. I think that it's useless to show thousands of suggestions, no one would keep scrolling until the bottom. So we can, for example, limit the number of suggestions to 100. By doing so, our autocomplete feature becomes way smoother as you can see. We're getting enough suggestions, but not all of them to avoid having an annoying delay. And we finished implementing the autocomplete feature. Obviously, we can make a more complex autocomplete tool like the Google's one. It can handle the cases where what we wrote is in the middle, cases where there is a typing mistake, and many other ones. There is also another interesting implementation for autocomplete. It's by using binary search. We store our strings sorted by lexicographic order, then we use binary search to find a string that starts with our prefix, by comparing the first m characters where m is the length of the prefix. From there, we keep going to both directions to retrieve all the strings that start with that prefix. Remember that our strings are sorted, so they will be adjacent. It's a classic binary search. The difference is that instead of comparing integers, we compare the lexicographic order of the first m characters of the string and the prefix. We reached the end of this video. In this one, we've seen a real-life application of a data structure implementing the autocomplete feature. I hope that you understood the material presented in this video and the one before it. Like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.